It's one of the center, and he's heading our education technology team. And Deeksha happens to be our first MA education batch student. And Sada and Deeksha both would be taking the session with you. And I'll now request Sada to start the session. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you so much, and Poonam, and welcome everybody on Saturday's afternoon. I hope you all had a good meal and now actually ready to discuss with us how can we make social sciences more interesting, engaging, and actually make the teaching learning process in the classroom for social sciences a creative pursuit. So we, in the course of next 1 hour, we will basically discuss about some of the problems that social science teaching is currently facing and how it can be improved. And then we'll also look at the broader objectives of teaching social sciences. And after that, we want to actually focus more on some examples of doing social sciences, how social science teaching can be made more joyful and engaging through some demonstrable examples. During the discussion, we actually want to make the discussion more interactive. But more often, keeping everybody unmuted actually keeps distraction. So for now, I will actually disable the unmute option so that our discussion can happen smoothly. But you will be able to raise your hand and also put your thoughts and questions in the chat box, and then we will unmute you. Is that okay to go? With the strategy. Okay. You can also say yes by showing thumbs up or something in the I hope you get those icons. So without further ado, let us discuss. I don't know if the next slide is not coming up. Aksha, can you confirm if the slide yours? Okay, yeah, fine. I think there is a lag from due to the connectivity at my end. So, what are the present perceptions of social science in school? So these are some of the perceptions that we have found prevalent. But if you think these are not true, or you think a bit differently, then can you express either in the chat box, or if you can raise hand, we will unmute you. Okay, the perception is slowly changing. Okay, the perceptions that we have listed is that one, there is a perception that the social science is a non-utility subject. Okay, what does that mean? It means that there is little benefit or utility or real in everyday career aspect or in the everyday life, that is little that can be applicable from the social sciences. So that is the utility, a non-utility point of view that we have. मैं हिंदी भी बोल सकता हूँ क्या, ताकि बात को एक्सप्रेस करने में आसानी हो. बेसिकली माय मदर टंग इज उर्दू एंड दीक्षा इज आई थिंक पंजाबी, सो हमें बात करने में भी आसानी रहेगी इंग्लिश और हिंदी के मिक्सचर से. तो यूज क्या है सोशल साइंस पढ़ने का और पढ़ाने का, ये एक सवाल होता है ना हम जब भी पढ़ते हैं कोई भी सब्जेक्ट के बारे में, तो इसका फायदा क्या है, इसका यूज क्या है? तो एक परसेप्शन ये है कि सोशल साइंस का यूज बहुत कम है. दूसरा एक परसेप्शन ये है कि नेचुरल साइंसेस आर सुपीरियर टू सोशल साइंसेस. विद्या कह रही है कि अप्लाई और कनेक्टेड टू एवरीडे लाइफ इज लिमिटेड, राइट? एंड देन देयर इज अनदर परसेप्शन दैट ब्राइट स्टूडेंट जो होते हैं वो साइंसेस और मैथमेटिक्स को लेते हैं और सोशल साइंस कोई भी कर सकता है, क्योंकि उसका अगेन गोज बैक टू उसका महत्व उतना बहुत ज्यादा, उसका यूज उतना ज्यादा दिखाई नहीं देता है. फिर एक और परसेप्शन ये है कि सोशल साइंस में बस इंफॉर्मेशन ट्रांसमिट होती है, ये बेसिकली टेक्स्ट के सेंटर्ड होता है. यानी टेक्स्ट बुक में बहुत कुछ लिखा होता है, बस उसको सीख लेना है. एंड अनदर परसेप्शन इज दैट इसमें कोई बहुत ज्यादा साइंटिफिक रिगर और इंक्वायरी की चीज नहीं होती. जैसे केमिस्ट्री का एग्जाम्पल लेंगे तो उसमें एक्सपेरिमेंटेशन होते हैं, कुछ खोज होती है, कुछ दरियाफ्त करने का उसमें अपॉर्चुनिटी होती है. देयर इज सम साइंटिफिक रिगर, वी पायलट थिंग्स, वी टेक डाउन रीडिंग्स एंड देन वी कंक्लूड समथिंग. साइंटिफिक इंक्वायरी की अपॉर्चुनिटी सोशल साइंस में कम होती है. ये कुछ परसेप्शंस हैं. व्हाट डू यू थिंक? सो दिवाकर जी सेइंग दैट सोशल साइंस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू नो अबाउट सोसाइटी. यस, some believe that it is for students who cannot take up mathematics. Okay, so I think more or less aap log bhi is baat se agree kar rahe hain in perception se. Aur ye main batata chalun ki ye jo perceptions hain ye maine ya Diksha ne apne perceptions aapke samne nahi rakhe hain, balki these perceptions, I mean whatever here are taken from National Curriculum Framework 2005 ke document se. Okay, so it is coming from the literature, the research. Okay, now let us quickly look at how is social science done in our schools. Hum log सोशल साइंस अपनी क्लासरूम में कैसे करते हैं उसे, वैसे आप में से कोई अपना हैंड रेज करके बताएंगे कि कितने टीचर्स हैं जो सोशल साइंस पढ़ाते हैं अपनी क्लासरूम में? आप हैंड रेज कर सकते हैं या चैट में भी लिख सकते हैं. So that means there are few teachers who are from social science, but hum jo aaj ke is session mein jo discuss karenge, hame lagta hai ki ye asal mein hamara focus hai ki kaise active learning ko badhaya jaye classroom ke andar, foster kiya jaye. To kafi sare examples wo dusre jo practices hain wo dusre subject ke liye bhi useful ho sakte hain. So thank you everyone who have raised their hands. So how is social science done in our schools currently? Koi batana chahenge? Deepika ji, do you want to say? You can unmute. Gitan. Gitanjali. Okay. I have asked you to unmute.
Hello, good afternoon, sir. My name is Gitanjali. When I completed my schooling in 1999, mm-hmm. back then there was no technology, nothing. It was just whatever we got, it was through books. Science mm-hmm. was, since my childhood, I was inclined towards science. And mm-hmm. I was scared of maths and social.
Okay.
Both are not, whether it's maths or social or any subject, they're not boring. The way they have been taught and the way they have been presented in books is mm-hmm. very boring. And okay. I was scared of social, and I used to sleep in the social class. But when mm-hmm. it comes to I used to watch NGC, Animal Planet, and then Discovery Channel. It was quite interesting about astronomy, mm-hmm. the celestial bodies. It was very quite interesting. I always mm-hmm. thought why the teachers didn't teach us in this way.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it's not just social science is not a pure subject, not even science. Every subject is interlinked. They should be integrated.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That's what I believe.
Thank you. Yes. Thank you, Deepika ji. Gitanjali ji. Yeah. Anybody? Yeah. So we'll quickly move. So I think what Gitanjali was also saying कि हमारी textbooks में हम जैसे पढ़ाते हैं, जैसे present किया जाता है knowledge, वहाँ भी कुछ improvement की ज़रूरत है, है ना? तो और जो classroom का हमारा transaction है, वो social science के लिए बहुत ज़्यादा unique नहीं है, वो भी वैसे ही मेरे ख्याल में है, जैसे हम दूसरे subject के का transaction होता है, यानी कि हमारा जो basic फोकस होता है वो टेक्स्ट बुक्स होते हैं और फिर हमारे पास टीचर्स बहुत सारी वजूहात की बिना पर हमारे जो क्लासरूम का कल्चर है वो कि हम ट्रांसमिट करते हैं नॉलेज को और फिर आखिर में बच्चे जाकर एग्जाम लिखते हैं मार्क्स आते हैं लेकिन इस ये जो प्रक्रिया है ये जो प्रोसेस है इसमें बहुत सारे इश्यूज हैं गैप्स हैं और ब्लाइंड स्पॉट्स हैं हम उसको क्विकली देखेंगे एक तो बड़ा सा जो गैप है वो है डेवलपिंग पर्सपेक्टिव्स का कि सोशल साइंसेस असल में एक पर्सपेक्टिव बिल्ड करते हैं सोसाइटी के बारे में वर्ल्ड के बारे में है ना और पीपल के बारे में लेकिन हमारे इस ट्रांजैक्शन में काफी मर्तबा ये चीज मिसिंग हो जाती है और ये कहानी तो हम सबको पता है कि अगर किसी की मुख्तलिफ लोगों के आंख पर पट्टी बांधकर छोड़ दिया गया और बताया गया कि तुम्हें जो चीज महसूस होती है वो बोलो तो हाथी कैसा है बेसिकली उनको छोड़ दिया गया तो जिसने जिसके हाथ में जो चीज आई वो उसी को हाथी समझ बैठा था है ना तो किसी को हाथी रस्सी की तरह दिख रहा था तो किसी को पंखे की तरह दिख रहा था और किसी को दीवार की तरह दिख रहा था तो आई थिंक ये एक बहुत बड़ा गैप है जो हमारे सोशल साइंस में आता है और हम इसको कई बार नजरअंदाज कर देते हैं फॉर एग्जाम्पल हिस्ट्री के बारे में पढ़ते हुए हम ये देखते हैं कि हिस्ट्री कैसे कंस्ट्रक्ट होती है, हिस्ट्री को भी लिखा जाता है, एंड हाउ हिस्ट्री इज नॉट ओनली हिस्टोरियोग्राफ बट ऑल्सो हाउ इट इज नरेटेड इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड देन वी ऑल्सो नीड टू एक्नॉलेज द फैक्ट दैट कि हिस्ट्री के भी काफी पर्सपेक्टिव होते हैं, एक ही इवेंट मुख्तलिफ हिस्टोरियंस मुख्तलिफ नजरिए से उसको देख सकते हैं. देयर आर मल्टीपल नैरेटिव्स अबाउट अ सिंगल एपिसोड इन हिस्ट्री. सो वी हैव लिस्टेड डाउन क्वाइट अ फ्यू ब्लाइंड स्पॉट दैट वी ऑब्जर्व इन हिस्ट्री एंड रिसर्चर्स एंड हिस्टोरियंस ऑल्सो पॉइंट दीज आउट. अनदर issue that is there with our books are they are also written in different times and with different ideologies, and how we see history from a lens of presentism. Yani abhi hamari jo understanding hai cheezon ko lekar, hum us chashme ke dwara pichle history ko dekhne ki koshish karte hain. For example, abhi aaj ka 2020 ka daur hai, hamari apni kuch cultural practices hain, जमाने के अपने जनरल कुछ नॉर्म्स हैं, और हम चूंकि इस जगत में जी रहे हैं इस टाइम में, तो हमारा अपना मेंटल मॉडल कुछ बना हुआ है. अब हम उन फ्रेम्स को यूज करते हुए 1000 साल पुरानी वाली दुनिया को देखने की कोशिश करते हैं, तो इसमें काफी सारे प्रॉब्लम्स आ जाते हैं. सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द ब्लाइंड स्पॉट दैट आर देयर इन teaching of history. Similarly, geography और political science को लेकर भी कई सारे blind spots हमारे सामने दिखाई देते हैं. Diksha, you want to say anything in this regard?
No, sir. I think you can go ahead.
Okay. तो हम बेसिकली चाह रहे हैं कि हमारा ज्यादा आज का डिस्कशन हैंड्स ऑन चीजों पर हो, तो मैं क्विकली ये एक स्लाइड खत्म करके विल मूव टू हाउ डू वी डू थिंग्स. तो एनसीएफ 2005 का काफी ब्यूटीफुली रिटर्न पोजिशन पेपर है कि सोशल साइंस की टीचिंग कैसी की जाए. ये एनसीईआरटी की वेबसाइट पर आपको आसानी से मिल जाएगा. तो दे हैव लिस्टेड some 5-6 major objectives of teaching social science, and one of that is that social science isliye padhaya jana chahiye taki hum bachchon ke andar society ko lekar aur social norms ko lekar ek critical understanding develop ho ki hum jis samaj mein jeete hain wo samaj kya hai, wo samaj kaise bana hai. To ye ek major aim है सोशल साइंस को पढ़ाने का. एक दूसरा जो ऑब्जेक्टिव है वो है इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन की अंडरस्टैंडिंग का. इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन हमारा एक बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण फाउंडेशन और गाइडिंग बुक है जो कि हमारी सोसाइटी को चलाने में मदद करती है, हमारी आज की इंडियन सोसाइटी को. फिर हम सोशल साइंस पढ़ाने का ये भी एक मकसद होना चाहिए कि हमारे स्टूडेंट्स आगे चलकर ही नहीं बल्कि आज भी रिस्पॉन्सिबल और रिफ्लेक्टिव सिटीजन्स बन पाए, मेंबर्स ऑफ सोसाइटी बन पाए, एंड दे रिस्पेक्ट डिफरेंसेस, क्योंकि हमारी सोसाइटी में काफ़ी सारे डिफरेंसेस हैं, और उन डिफरेंसेस के साथ एक दूसरे का सम्मान करते हुए कैसे हम अपनी आइडेंटिटी को भी बाकी रख सकें, उसको नर्चर कर सकें, ये भी एक स्किल है जो कि सोशल साइंसेस के जरिए से हम बताना चाहते हैं. एंड वी ऑल्सो वॉन्ट अ चिल्ड्रन टू क्वेश्चन एंड एग्जामिन क्रिटिकली जो भी उनको दिया जाता है, तभी हमारी सोसाइटी तरक्की करेगी, आगे बढ़ेगी. जब तक यंगस्टर्स हमारे क्वेश्चन और एग्जामिन नहीं करेंगे क्रिटिकली, तो दिस आर सम ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स दैट एनसीएफ 2005 आइडेंटिफाइज फॉर टीचिंग ऑफ सोशल साइंसेस. तो हमने क्विकली देखा कि हमारी सोशल साइंस की आज की जो प्रक्रिया है टीचिंग लर्निंग की, उसमें कुछ प्रॉब्लम्स हैं, कुछ इश्यूज हैं, कुछ ब्लाइंड स्पॉट्स हैं और कुछ गैप्स हैं. तो हमें इन गैप्स को कैसे हम दूर कर सकते हैं, और शुरू में हमने देखा कि एक बड़ा प्रॉब्लम परसेप्शन का भी है, जिसकी वजह से हमारे ब्राइट स्टूडेंट्स इन पर्टिकुलर और इन जनरल बच्चे सोशल साइंस में बहुत ज्यादा इंटरेस्ट नहीं दिखा पाते हैं. तो आइए हम देखते हैं कि कैसे हम इन ऑब्जेक्टिव्स को अचीव करने के लिए और इन गैप्स को दूर करने के लिए और बच्चों में इंटरेस्ट पढ़ाने के लिए टू नर्चर इंटरेस्ट इन सोशल साइंस एंड टू मेक इट मोर एंगेजिंग हाउ कैन वी मेक सम एक्टिविटीज. तो ओवर टू दीक्षा.
Thank you, sir, and good afternoon, everyone. I think sir has already covered a lot of about developing perspective. कि जैसे आज जिस तरह हम अपने समाज को समझते हैं वो हम अपने पास्ट में झांकते हैं और अंडरस्टैंडिंग बनाने की कोशिश करते हैं कि हम प्रेजेंट स्टेट में कैसे पहुँचे. बट जैसे कि चैट बॉक्स में लोगों ने लिखा कि फोकस जनरली ऐसे रहता है कि या तो वॉर्स पे रहता है या हम ब्रिटिशर्स के पर्सपेक्टिव से अपनी कंट्री को देख रहे हैं. कॉमन मैन का व्यू नहीं आ रहा है जो कि एकदम सही बात है. तो ये ज़रूरत है कि उन लाइंस के अलोंग भी थिंकिंग ट्रिगर की जा सके. सो हम हिस्ट्री कैसे को किस तरह से देखते हैं कि कुछ हमें एविडेंस मिलता है और उसके बेस पे हम नैरेटिव्स बिल्ड करते हैं. इसको एक सिंपल एग्जांपल की तरह सोचा जा सकता है कि लाइक एशियन पेंट जैसे कहता है कि हर घर कुछ कहता है, हम ये कह सकते हैं कि हर घर का कचरा भी कुछ कहता है. So what has happened in the history of developing these textbooks and all is that we are looking at garbage of only one particular household. Ki jaise raja maharaja ka dekh liya, ब्रिटिशर्स के राजा महाराजा का और एक घर का आप कचरा देखते हो. आपको कुछ आइटम्स मिलती हैं उसके बेस पे आप कुछ नैरेटिव बिल्ड करने की कोशिश करते हो कि इस घर में कौन कौन हो सकता है, किस तरह की एक्टिविटीज में एंगेज हो सकते हैं. तो जैसे ब्रिटिशर्स का पर्सपेक्टिव को समझने के लिए कि उन्होंने कुछ एविडेंस सिलेक्टेड एविडेंस लिए और उनके फॉर्म पे उसके बेस पे नैरेटिव बिल्ड किया. सो अब इस तरह की थिंकिंग क्लास में हम डिजिटल टूल्स की तरह कैसे ट्रिगर कर सकते हैं, उसके लिए काफ़ी सारी एक्टिविटीज हैं ये. बट ये वाली एक्टिविटी ओपन एंडेड है अभी के लिए. आप लोग एट द एंड ऑफ द सेशन वी आर होपिंग दैट यू कैन थिंक ऑफ यूजिंग सम टूल्स एंड ट्रिगरिंग थिंकिंग अलोंग दीज लाइंस. सर यू कैन टेक इट फॉरवर्ड.
ओके, यू वांट टू डिस्क्राइब द how can one build narratives from the item?
Yeah, like I can give an example. Suppose in the trash can of one household, you find pic of a small kid or a wedding invitation card for addressed to Mr. and Mrs. Bhatia, and then you get a railway ticket or a boarding pass which mentions Mrs. Siddiqui. You can also have a broken needle in that garbage can. Now, what kind of narratives with this evidence, what kind of narratives you can build? Now, if you do this sort of activity with students in class, I would leave this question to you, like, what kind of narratives they can come up with. Sir?
Yeah. Thanks, Diksha. So, Diksha bata rahi thi ke history jaise build hoti hai, jaise construct hoti hai, usme bahut sare evidences ka istemal kiya jata hai. Ek to hai material evidences, jo ASI जो डिपार्टमेंट होता है हमारा, जो हिस्टोरिकल साइट्स का सर्वे करता है और वहां से तारीख को खोज के निकालता है बेसिकली. सो देयर आर मटेरियल्स दैट help decide about history. There are, and the second thing is the narratives about history. If somebody has written a diary, if somebody has written a book, then the history also refers to such resources, such sources, and then a narrative is built. So currently in the chat also, somebody has mentioned that whatever the current history, whatever we see, is largely dependent on the British colonial narrative of India, isn't it? If we consider Indian history. If we consider the world history as well, the history is written usually by rulers and the winners. So it gives one aspect of what happened in history. So what you can do is, आप ऐसे एक्टिविटी अपने आसपास में बता सकते हैं इस बात को समझाने के लिए कि हिस्ट्री कई सारी लेयर्स के साथ होती है ना, और कई सारी चीजें मिलकर ट्रायंगुलेशन किया जाता है, देन एक कंक्लूजन निकाला जाता है. तो इस बात को समझाने के लिए वी कैन डिवाइस सम एक्टिविटी. तो इसका एक उदाहरण दीक्षा ने दिया कि कैसे हम गार्बेज का एक एग्जाम्पल लेकर देख सकते हैं कि ये गार्बेज कहाँ से आया है, उस फैमिली का बैकग्राउंड क्या है, इस चीज को हम लोग समझने की कोशिश कर सकते हैं. तो आप देखेंगे की गई है, तो क्लासरूम में हर एक स्टूडेंट का अपना एक परसेप्शन होता है चीजों को लेकर कि किसके घर में मिल सकती है, तो हम उसे क्लासरूम के अंदर डिस्कशन करा सकते हैं. Diksha is reminding me that we need to, we are left with 30 minutes. So we'll slightly move ahead so that we will have some dedicated time for discussion with you all. The second activity that can be taken is creating historical narrative through multi-layered timeline. Hamare saamne aksar jo history ki टाइमलाइन नजर आती है, इट इट कम्स एज अ वेरी व्हाट वी कैन कॉल अ वेरी लीनियर एंड डिसकनेक्टेड काइंड ऑफ अ टाइमलाइन. सो देर इज सम स्टोन एज विच इज सम 1000 इयर्स बीसी वेयर सम पीपल यूज्ड टू डू सम थिंग्स. And then we do fast forward and come to Greek history, isn't it? Which is again around 1000 year or few hundred years BC. And then we skip many hundred years and then come to some other civilization. And then we skip another few hundred years and skip to 12th century. And whatever we don't cover, we call them as basically dark age, which uska perception hamare dimag mein ye ban gaya ki dark age matlab ye nahi ki hamare paas uski information nahi hai, balki ye ki us samay insaan bahut hi dark age mein jeeta tha, yani usko kuch pata nahi tha. And then we again fast forward with industrial revolution. We see that there are some body inventing or discovering about gravity and somebody inventing about printing press. And then we again have at the same time a colonial period and imperial period wherein many rajas, maharajas and sultans were ruling at the same time. We also discuss in a same very tone, there is Delhi Sultanate, right? And then we also have Marathas and Travancore, Nawabs, and other Maharajas and Rajas. So, isme ek problem ye hota hai ki hum sari cheezon ko ek bahut hi linear way mein describe karte hain, aur ultimately students are very much cognitively loaded because they are not able to interconnect. There are so many wars in between. And then there is so much need to remember exact dates, hai na, Panipat ki ladai kab hui thi, uska exact date hi chahiye hai. So I think to have a bigger understanding, to meta understanding of how things are, were flowing at a given particular period of time, timelines can be used. Okay, तो इसके जरिए से एक interconnectedness build की जा सकती है between different episodes in history. Okay, इसका एक छोटा सा उदाहरण, एक टूल है H5P. Okay, आप इसकी वेबसाइट पर जा सकते हैं और अपना अकाउंट बनाकर बना सकते हैं. लेकिन H5P एक बेसिकली टूल है जो कि फ्री एंड ओपन सोर्स है, और अगर आपके पास मूडल का LMS है या फिर वर्डप्रेस बेस्ड कोई अपनी वेबसाइट है, तो आप इसके सारे फीचर्स को फ्री में मूडल या वर्डप्रेस वेबसाइट के साथ इंटीग्रेट कर सकते हैं. और इसके बहुत सारे ब्यूटीफुल इंटरैक्टिव्स हैं, जिसमें से एक है टाइमलाइन क्रिएशन. तो हम देखते हैं कि हिस्ट्री ऑफ स्ट्रॉबेरी की इन्होंने एक टाइमलाइन इसके द्वारा बनाई गई है. तो बेसिकली हमें टाइमलाइन में टाइम डिफाइन करना पड़ता है, उसके बाद जो माइलस्टोन्स या इवेंट्स होते हैं हमें उसको क्रिएट करना होता है. यहाँ पर दिखाया गया है कि ओरिजिन ऑफ स्ट्रॉबेरी, ओके, वो 300 बीसी में आई थी. पहले तो हम टाइमलाइन का एक इंट्रोडक्शन देंगे कि ये हिस्ट्री ऑफ स्ट्रॉबेरीज था और उसके बारे में ये टाइमलाइन है. कुछ इमेजेस लेंगे, फिर इसकी ओरिजिन कैसे हुई तो उसके बारे में थोड़ा सा एक्सप्लोर करके इमेजेस के साथ उसको लिखा जाएगा, और हिस्ट्री में वो एपिसोड कब हुआ था हम उसको आइडेंटिफाई कर सकते हैं. फिर स्ट्रॉबेरीज का हिस्ट्री में अर्ली मेंशन कहाँ पे हमें मिलता है लिटरेचर में, इसके बारे में थोड़ा सा नरेशन है. अब देखते हैं कि 300 बीसी से फिर जंप हुआ और ये आया 1200 टू 1300 मिडिल एजेस में. तब स्ट्रॉबेरी को कैसे लोग इस्तेमाल करते थे, फिर स्ट्रॉबेरी का कल्टीवेशन उस एज के आसपास ही हुआ. सो यू कैन सी देयर लेयर्स, है ना, एक साथ में आ रहा है. एक साथ नरेशन है मिडिल एजेस में कैसे स्ट्रॉबेरीज थे, तो उसके अंदर कल्टीवेशन इन यूरोप का नरेशन है. एंड देन हाउ इट वेंट टू नॉर्थ अमेरिका. हम देख रहे हैं कि टाइमलाइन इज देयर एंड देन देयर इज नरेशन. दिस इज एन एग्जाम्पल. अब हम ये तो यहाँ पे रेडी एग्जाम्पल थी. हम लोग चाह रहे थे कि हम कोई टेक्स्ट बुक से एक टॉपिक लेकर हम उसकी एग्जाम्पल बना पाए, लेकिन हम अभी सोच सकते हैं कि किस तरह के टॉपिक्स को लेकर हम टाइमलाइन बना सकते हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इंडिया की फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल. इफ यू आस्क स्टूडेंट्स टू फॉर्म ग्रुप्स और फिर उनको ये बताएं कि आप लोग इंडिया की फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल की एक टाइमलाइन बनाइए, और वी कैन ऑल्सो रेस्ट्रिक्ट इट टू इंडिया फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल आफ्टर गदर की लड़ाई, है ना, 1957. व्हाट वर द डिफरेंट एपिसोड्स दैट वर प्लेइंग आउट, राइट? देयर वर सो मेनी सोशल चेंजेस हैपनिंग, देयर वर सो मेनी स्ट्रक्चरल चेंजेस हैपनिंग, देयर वर सो मेनी राजास एंड महाराज somewhere fighting against the British, somewhere collaborating with the Britishers, and there were so many kinds of freedom struggles that were going on, right? So, तो ये basically history एक काफी complex interconnections के जरिए से हमारे सामने नजर आती है. अगर हम इस तरह से एक complex timeline को एक historical narrative build करने की कोशिश करेंगे, और इसके जरिए से ये हो सकता है कि बच्चों के अंदर हिस्टोरिकल इंक्वायरी का एक सेंस पैदा होगा. ओके, एंड अ लॉन्ग व्यू ऑफ इवेंट्स कैन आल्सो बी डेवलप, कि हम साइलोज में किसी एक इवेंट को देखने के बजाय एक उसका बिग पिक्चर हमारे सामने आ सकता है. ओके, सो दिस इज वन सच एक्टिविटी वी कैन डू. Another activity that can be done is virtual tours. हमारे पास हिस्ट्री की बुक में बहुत सारी चीजें आती हैं. सो आई थिंक या दीक्षा यू वांट टू टेक इट फॉरवर्ड.
यस सर, जस्ट लेट मी शेयर माय स्क्रीन. इज इट विजिबल सर? हेलो.
यस
ओके. या सो सर आई विल यूज इंग्लिश बिकॉज़ देयर वाज रिक्वेस्ट in the chat box for the same. So someone mentioned in the chat that social science is seen as a very dry subject, and so to introduce a little bit of make it a little bit interactive, or you can say making sense of the things that are around you, and what as a society we have thought, what are our major milestones or the things that we considered valuable for our cultural heritage. So for that, visiting museums can be a great activity. So now with the affordance of technology, we can visit many places at a time through these tools. So one is the first that I would like to mention is this virtual museums which our Ministry of Culture has put together at one platform. And specifically, I have opened it so that we don't lose on the time. I have opened Museums of India from here. And see, here you can look at different resources that we have preserved over time. And there is also theme-based categorization. So if you go to the musical instruments, so one can, I think it is taking time to load, but in one picture, you can see how our society has created so much kind of various instruments and variation of the same. Like one would look at something like mridangam and say that, okay, this might be the only thing that exists, but within that, how much modification you can make to make new instruments, that can also be seen. Now quickly, I'll go to another platform, Google Arts and Culture, which you can explore at your end. I'll show about, I'll go to historic events, and maybe we can look at the Indian independence movement here. In the form of a story. So how it all started. And what is interesting about these platforms that they also put a photo or some document that was signed or some letter that also gives a very rich narrative. Someone was mentioning that textbooks don't give you a lot of opportunity for including a lot of things. So that this way the students can also see that how how these evidences or letters that are preserved, how they are interpreted in making the narrative. Another interesting thing that I'll just maybe put here, if you want to look at heritage side that affordability also this platform gives, and it also little things like some textual information that also tells that how these heritage sites were discovered. So it's not like that, like earlier, like when I was a kid, we were just given a scrapbook where we had to paste the number of some number of heritage sites in different states. But this form of narrative actually tells you how do archaeologists maybe discover these sites and what they mean. So yeah, I'll just quickly go back. You can explore these tools at your end, and a lot of activities can be designed around these tools. Like you can ask students to visit local heritage site that might not be listed in some sort of specialized curated or heritage sites, and then look about that space. And we can, using some tools that Sir has discussed, like H5P, it also gives you affordances to create your own narrative, like what this heritage site meant for the society around. Students can go about interviewing their parents or their grandparents and create a narrative for themselves. Sir? Sir?
Should we... Yes, is it audible now?
I can hear you. Yes, sir. Okay. I've stopped screen share, maybe.
Yeah. Should we stop here and take a few questions or complete a few more activities and keep the discussion at the end?
So if it can be extended, maybe then we can have questions now.
Yeah. So, Poonam, till what time we can continue?
We have, yeah, we can. It's 3:50. So okay. Another 15 minutes you can. Send for 5 minutes, 5-10 minutes.
Okay. Yeah. So I think, Diksha, let us finish because there are only some 2-3 more activities, and then we can open up for the discussion. Okay. So another activity that we can plan is about maps. So so far the activities we narrated were majorly focusing on developing historical understanding, historical narrative, and how children can get to know about different aspects of history education. Now, an important component of social sciences is also geography. And in geography, again, the information that is given in the book and the methods of teaching are also very linear. And for example, we see geography with the maps, and the maps we have are very static. There is less or basically no interactivity in that available. And we see boundaries as a given thing, that as if they were already always there. And then we also categorize and classify geography into very what we can call very superficially in terms of how they appear physically, I mean naturally, and without considering much about the inhabitants of that geography, like without considering much about the cultural traits or the people of a region. So one way to develop, which ultimately what it gives is a very linear or not very deep understanding of geography. So one way to we can adopt is create interactive maps. Before that, I think this is also very interesting. the ISRO has an app called Bhuvan, portal basically, on which they have given multiple layers of maps from the satellite imagery. So we can actually ask students to first explore. This might be very much for informational purpose, but it gives a multi-dimensional understanding of how our geography is. For example, if we look at our geography from a climatic point of view, that is based on the seasons and the climatic conditions, how does the Indian geography look like? So here it gives the details about, based on the annual rainfall, how the Indian geography looks like, which are the places where there are high rainfall, low rainfall, and what do we mean by high rainfall and low rainfall? These can be explored using this. And then if we want to see how the monsoon advances, its onset, where does it start, where does it end, and how different monsoon seasons actually progress, and how monsoon retreats. Okay. So I think these are very, these will be very interesting. And in, since in one canvas, it gives so many dimensions about the geographic condition of a territory, it will evoke many more questions among children, and they will be intrigued to ask questions. If you look at major rivers, how do they flow? Where do they originate? And then we can actually create discussion about around these topics. Why certain area do not have rivers? And when there are rivers, then how do they flow, et cetera, et cetera. And what are the implications of that? If we look at natural vegetation and wildlife, then what are these? What are the different kinds of forests? What are the different wildlife sanctuaries that are available? Okay, they're tropical forests. What do they mean? There are mangroves forests. What do they mean? Okay, I think this is a very interesting tool which we can use to explore a multidimensional understanding of how maps are. Many people are doing interesting work in making maps more interactive, engaging, and contextual, because a lot of time in geography, we read about the broader geography of a nation or the world or a continent. And then many times we miss about knowing our own city or town's geography, right? When I was a child, I was very interested to get a map of my city. And at that time, it was hardly available, but there are tools through which we can ask students to make such customized maps of their own location, their own city, their own village. And one such activity that our colleague has done in some parts of Assam, I believe, or West Bengal, is that wherein children actually explored the flow of a river in their small town, and how over a period of time the river changed its direction. So they interviewed people, they draw on the map how the river flowed, etc., etc. So there is this tool called UMAP, which allows you to create maps. You can log in, or without login also you can create map, but if you log in, you will preserve whatever maps you create, which basically gives you the entire map of the world, and you can create different kinds of atlases based on that. And it gives you lot many controls about places, since that is very constrained on time. So if we take India, for example, and then we can actually look at India at a very different manner. For example, how many of times we have discussed the food map of India, right? In India, we always talk about diversity, but then in India, different, almost every region has a different unique culinary practices. So you can ask to for children to develop a map with each state's popular dishes, or your own city's or district's or state's culinary or food habits map. So there are so many controls. I think the time does not allow me to do that. But if you just explore a bit, you will be able to do. UMAP is a free and open source. The other way to do is also you can create with Google Maps. So if you have a Gmail account, then you can create Google Maps-based personalized maps. The screen is taking time to change. Yeah. So this is how you can similarly make a map out of it. Food map of Maharashtra, for example. Okay. You can now add multiple layers, etc. So many controls that are available. Okay, you can make, you can identify places, you can identify particular geographies, etc. Okay, now this can actually develop so many skills among children: geospatial understanding, a multi-layered understanding of graphs and geography can be developed. Another, yeah, Diksha, you want to quickly cover this and then we can.
Yes, open. Sir. Just a second. Yeah, so this question about how a democracy actually works was something that bothered me a lot during my school years. Like we had to remember how a bill was passed, how many members are there in the Lok Sabha. But how things turn out in practice, that affordance was not there at that time. But now, yeah, we have a lot of tools thanks to technology. And how do we, like, whatever we learn, how do we make sense of it? So one way of trying to understand this whole bureaucratic structure or governance system or how democratic processes work can be through mind mapping. So there's this one tool, Graph Commons, in which what you can do, suppose you want to tell students that Constitution is a live document. We all read that in our textbooks. But how now students go about exploring whether it is true or not? So suppose, and textbooks also mention that the 86th Amendment. So what I can do through mind mapping is, okay, 86th Amendment happened, but why did it suddenly happen? What were the events that led to that, and how much impact did they have? So what you can, one can do is just use this tool and enter the node type. Suppose I'm talking about amendments here, and I'll label the same as 86th amendment. Okay, that happened. Now, suppose I look at, like, what are the events that led to it, then only Krishnan judgment is very important. So there is this ruling, Unnikrishnan judgment. So it also helps me to connect how acts are passed, What role does the judiciary play, and what kind of events can it lead to? Like RT was passed as a result. So I can connect these two. And it also talk, here I can also enter like what kind of relation they share. So I can just say that it impacted. And I can also change, like suppose it strongly impacted. So from here, if I go on increasing this, then the thickness of this this node would also be more. I have created the complete thing, not the complete thing, but trying to figure out like what happened. Here you can have more nodes, RT was passed, then Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan happened. But there are also a lot of affordances here. Like you can, for each node, you can add more data. Like, okay, what was 86th Amendment about? Or you can also through the, these sort of tools make your students also digitally very aware of what kind of tools, what kind of references you should look at, what kind of references you should avoid. So it also, these tools also helps to build a kind of digital citizenship also. There are many elements to it. I'm just referring to one of them. So I'll just show here. So here I had entered data about the 86th amendment. And so if I click on it, I have added the reference to what it took. So it tells me like what the amendment was about and from where I'm taking this data, I can add here. There are other features as well, like you can add more properties if you want to. You can add YouTube links as well here. But this software only you can create, I think, up to 5 graphs here. So once you create, if you have used it, maybe delete it and reuse it. But this is just to show like what kind of things can do with such tools. Of course, there are other tools available like Freeplane. That is also a mind mapping software, which you can explore further. I'll just quickly take you to we talk about Lok Sabha in textbooks, and we in our daily life we keep on saying that politicians aren't doing anything, we don't know what they do in the parliament. So the website, this Lok Sabha website by the Government of India, that can also be a way of figuring out how things work, how bills gets passed. But first to start, suppose you have to look at attendance of your representatives, whether they are over a period of time. So you can just change sessions here and dates here. And then what you can do, you can create you can even use some simple tools like spreadsheets you can use to trigger students thinking about how accountable our representatives actually are. So they've just put here just random numbers. And then you can see like, okay, there are so many members in the Lok Sabha, but on a given day, how many actually attend? So that can be one activity. Another things you can do, like if you go to here, I can't see it now, but yeah. How bill becomes an act. One is this kind of description that we also find in a textbook. Suppose a student is interested, okay, in the field of education or in the field of environmental science, how many bills have been passed? and on a given day, which bills are introduced. So you can just go to this place and look at the ministry you are. This also tells that there are specific ministries under which some subjects fall. And then you can look at one of them, like which bills have been passed, and see, it tells that, okay, that was passed in Lok Sabha, passed in Rajya Sabha. But the student doesn't need to grab these things. Yeah. So based on that, they can again use spreadsheets to make a lot of kind of inferences. Okay, these many bills were passed. Or another things they can look at, okay, how many, whether there's an increase in women representation in the Lok Sabha. So it gives a lot of information about how we have as a society involved. We talk of social justice, but are those things happening in actuality? Yeah. So?
Yeah. Thanks, Iksha. Can you go to next?
Yes.
This is the last activity that we wanted to suggest. The sixth one.
Yes, sir.
The previous slide.
Yes, sir.
Is that you can choose, somebody was asking, how can we discuss or talk about nationalism, conservatism, liberalism, etc., etc. So I think these can be discussed creating some scenarios and having a discussion on that. TED also has some very interesting videos on that. The sixth activity we wanted is one of the objectives, as we have seen, is to have to develop students as active citizens. So we come across so many institutions, as Diksha was saying. One is to review how they function. The second is also to engage with them. How many of times we take our children to a police station or municipal council office, right? So in every municipal council office, there will be a city survey office, which will tell you how the city's geography has been changing over the period of time. So we can interact with those public officers, right? And we can take them to council and make them watch council proceedings, municipal council proceedings. We can get them speak with the police officials, how do they function, how the crimes happen, etc., and why the laws happen and how the laws have come to be, right? So I think these are some of the ways in which we can actually take students out of the classroom and, you know, realize how things actually work out as a system in a society. So next one, Diksha. To summarize, I think the thrust that we have been trying to suggest is that teaching and learning of social sciences should inculcate a critical thinking skills in our students. And for that, they need to collaboratively inquire about various aspects of social sciences, history, economics, political science. And they also need to research and do triangulation, go to sources and collect data. And so social sciences has a scientific component within that. And then they need to raise questions, ask questions, etc. Finally, I think next one. Yeah. So the contestations are basically very much essential. Diksha, you want to tell? And we'll just open up.
I think, sir, in the whole presentation, we tried to bring this point across, whether it was in the historical aspect or geography or political science, everything. Like in the political science, we just looked at, okay, that can be one way of contestation, like how your leaders work, and then you know about what these processes are, then how you now engage in this. And I think that's exactly an that is a purpose of doing social science, that how do we live in a society, engage and make a better word out of it, and which also upholds some of the principles like mentioned in the Constitution and a lot of our other documents, like about social justice. So if you are missing some particular narrative from the history and it is only focused on certain groups, I think that is also a grave injustice. And students need to be, their minds should be like triggered along these lines to make sense of it. And yeah, for that, contestations are essential.
Thanks a lot, Diksha. So you might, one question that keep on arising when we suggest these activities are that it is very difficult to have such activities alongside so much of portion and examination burden. What we would encourage you to do is identify some topics, at least one active learning activity in history, one in geography, one in political science, and try this out in some of the grades, and then let us see what kind of learning students with students happen. Yeah, I think thank you. We took we tried to cover a broad range of things. So now you are able to unmute also if you have any thoughts to share, question to ask, suggestions to make, then you're welcome to do.
Sir, I'm Geetanjali again.
Yeah.
Sir, it was very interesting. I wish I had these tools when I was in school.
Right. We all wish that.
Yeah. And I missed the earlier sessions. I attended the last week's science session. Mm-hmm. But before that, maths and English sessions I missed. So, okay. Is there are they available on YouTube?
Yes, I believe some of the sessions have been recorded. So, Poonam, I think it will be useful if we share across the our channel link.
Yes, it is there, and we'll share the link with you. It'll be soon on the website. This website also, Tata Institute of Social Sciences website.
The previous sessions, ma'am?
Yes, the recordings of the sessions.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. Thank you, yeah. Diksha, ma'am.
So anybody else want to share anything? Or...
Any more questions? Then we can close our session and thank our speakers. So, shall we close the session, Sada?
Yes, Poonam. So, I have listed, I've shared the YouTube link of our center, so they can refer to that. And there are, these are some of the links that you can keep referring to. We also keep on sharing such practices and active learning strategies and tools on our
excuse website. Me, Sadak bhai.
Yes.
Am I audible to you, sir?
Yes, yes.
Yes, sir. Yeah, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh mein map painting ke liye bahut zaruri hai sab. Ye map painting mein places achcha taraf se locate karne ke liye ya paper 1 paper 2 mein kuch tips batate kya aap? आपने मैडम और कौर मैडम और आप कोई तो भी कुछ लोकेशंस के बारे में या इंडिया में नहीं तो प्रपंच में कुछ लोकेशन इजी से इजी तरफ सम टिप्स कुछ रहता है ना आप जानते मेरे ख्याल से ज्यादा जानते हैं आप कुछ एनी कुछ टिप्स कुछ यूज बहुत यूज रहता
नहीं एग्जैक्टली किसके बारे में मैप में
लोकेशंस के बारे में मैप रीडिंग जो है ना मैप मैप लोकेशन है ना लोकेटिंग द प्लेसेस जो रहता है ना
ओके
वो प्लेसेस के लिए कैसे लोकेट रखना अच्छा से नहीं, आपको कुछ ज्यादा आइडिया रहता बोल के मैं
आपको
पूछ रहा
मैप बनाना है
ना, ना बना नहीं, मैप बना के देने के बाद उसमें लोकेट करते हैं ना प्लेसेस, हाँ
ओके ओके,
वो
तो वो कैसे करें?
हाँ जरा इजी, एनी कुछ, एनी कुछ टिप्स है तो जरा
हाँ,
कुछ इन्फॉर्मेशन दीजिए।
ठीक है, जो यू मैप और गूगल मैप हमने बताया ना, उसके अंदर ऐसे काफी सारे अच्छे कंट्रोल्स हैं, आप लेबल कर सकते हैं
जी
मैप्स को, क्रिएट करने के बाद टैग कर सकते हैं उसमें, मीडिया फाइल जैसे इमेज ऑडियो वीडियो वगैरह उसको टैग कर सकते हैं। आप एक्सप्लोर कीजिए, अगर आपको और कोई सहायता चाहिए तो आप हमारा ईमेल कर दीजिए।
हाँ जी हाँ जी हाँ जी, ओके ओके, थैंक यू, धन्यवाद भाई साहब, सेशन इज वेरी गुड सर,
या थैंक यू सो मच फॉर बीइंग हियर। ये हमारा ईमेल आईडी है, आप इस पे ही ईमेल कर सकते हैं।
सर आई हैव अनदर क्वेश्चन, आई हैड गॉन थ्रू द टिस वेबसाइट यस्टरडे and there were some cool the COL cool programs, one of them was free resources for teachers, so it was conducted in May, is there anything I missed it, I didn't know about it, so is there anything coming up something like that in the future?
Yes, तो cool के काफी सारे रिसोर्स अभी भी अवेलेबल हैं, जो लिंक्स वहाँ पे दिए गए हैं ना, आप उस लिंक पर जाइए। तो बेसिकली टीचर्स के लिए हमने काफी सारे फ्री कोर्सेज भी अवेलेबल किए थे, कुछ कोर्सेज अभी क्लोज हो चुके हैं लेकिन काफी सारे कोर्सेज अभी भी ओपन हैं, आप उस लिंक पर जाइए और आप एक्सेस कर सकते हैं। So, I think let us wind up.
Yeah, we'll just wind up. Thank you so much, Sadakat and Diksha. So, we'll just close the session. Yeah. Thank you, all the participants. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
I would just like to mention that participants might also be exploring many tools for teaching social science or for learning for themselves. So if they have anything good that they think it's good in their bag, they please feel free to share it with us on to our mail IDs. And yeah.
Hello. Am I audible?
Yes.
So good afternoon, everybody, Mr. Sadakat and everybody. So you have given such a good, wonderful presentation and taken out your valuable time. So I think what is missing here is the children generally have been taught right from the childhood that don't mind, you can become successful and earn money when you learn either engineering, doctor, or something. They are never told if you become a geologist, if you become a historian, or if you become one of these professionals from social science background, that you can be successful, right? So if right from the childhood, if we teachers can also tell them that social science is as important and relevant and also gives you successful opportunities in life at par with engineering, at par with doctor, at par with whatever you call, and give them examples of people who have been successful in their careers from social science background. So this will motivate them automatically to give more focus on this and make a wonderful career in this subject. So in that case, whatever these tools are there, and then the innovation technology and the efforts we teachers are giving, they all will add up to that. And I definitely think social science would come a long way in becoming a very major subject in our today's world. I think you can add something to this.
Thank you. I think you have pointed out to some pertinent issues that our social sciences is facing. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, everyone. We'll close the session now. Thanks.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you so much.